On our last petroleum field trip, we looked at how ancient organisms buried deep in the earth can turn into oil and natural gas deposits.
We also followed a seismic crew as they sent powerful vibrations off underground rock formations to help petroleum companies find where to drill their wells.
Today we're going to channel our inner roughneck as we watch our rig crew setting up a drilling rig and drill deep into the ground.
Before the job can begin, a crew has to build a road to the site. Then they prepare a pad for the rig and build barriers to contain any spills that might happen.
Once the road is built and the site is ready, the equipment arrives. Now it's time to put everything together, a job that petroleum workers call rigging up.
Some rigs are folded like a jackknife. This makes it easier to transport and set up quickly.
All the other parts of the rig come in modules, ready to be put in place and connected together, like a giant model.
A drilling rig is kind of like a handyman's power drill, only much bigger. Just like a drill, a rig has a drilling bit, and a motor that turns the bit to drill a hole.
Only, in this case, that hole might be hundreds of meters deep.
In the mud mixing shack, workers blend together a special mixture of water and chemicals for the drilling fluid, known as mud. A mud pump sends the mixture down through the drill pipe and through the drilling bit.
The mud helps keep the drill bit cool, and it also carries all of the rock chips and pieces back up to the surface. The mud then flows through a kind of filter called a shale shaker.
If the seismic survey was right, and it usually is, the drill will eventually hit oil, gas, or usually both. Then the crew starts a job called completion.
Workers thread a long pipe down into the hole. This is called the production casing. Next, they pump a cement mixture down through the pipe. The cement flows back up and around the outside of the pipe. As it hardens, it will hold the pipe in place.
When the production casing is ready, the crew moves the drilling rig and installs a smaller service rig. Then they put one more pipe, called the production tubing, down into the well.
Now, how do they get oil to flow into a steel pipe sealed in cement? They have to blast holes through it.
The crew lowers a device containing a number of explosive charges into the well. This is called a perforating gun. When the perforating gun is set off, each charge blasts a hole through the casing, the cement, and into the surrounding rock.
Then it's time to hook up a pump and start the oil flowing.
Today we saw a very common example of a drilling rig. However, there are many different types. Some rigs drill wells in reservoirs deep below the ocean floor.
But the overall process is always similar. Drill a deep hole, install a production casing, and put the oil or natural gas well to work.
If you'd like to drill even deeper into this topic, be sure to visit insideeducation.ca.
You can also send your questions to info@insideeducation.ca.
And that, as they say in the petroleum biz, is completion.
So long for now.